Hi everybody! Visual Studio 2022 is released, and in this video you will see all the new great features available there for WinForms applications. Very quickly about me, my name is Olya Gavrish, I'm Senior Program Manager on .NET team at Microsoft, and I'm working on WinForms, WPF, .NET MAUI, so if you have any questions on those areas, feel free to reach out to me on Twitter, I'll be happy to talk to you. And today we will cover what new features are coming with new Visual Studio and new .NET, .NET 6, what improvements have we made in WinForms area. Of course, we will do some coding together, and I will tell you what to expect next in the future. So, what is new? We enabled 64-bit support for WinForms and WPF applications. Yes, you asked us for it for a long time, and finally, 64-bit is fully supported. We also are adding new APIs per your requests, and we have application-wide default font, which I will show you in my demo. We are working on the new ways how you can bind to your data in your WinForms applications, so I'll show you a new data binding approach in WinForms. Also, we added designer support for strip controls such as menu strip, context menu strip, status strip, and so on. So now you can edit those controls in the designer using your mouse. No need to do the code behind. It has full support in the new designer. And we keep adding new controls. As for the new controls, in case you missed the announcement we had, we have a new task dialog, and that task dialog was added completely by our open source community. Konstantin Preiser was very passionate about this area, and he helped us implement an absolutely amazing advanced message box. You can think of it this way. So this task dialog can have footers, headers, buttons, checkboxes, progress bars, and so on. I absolutely love this control. Check it out. Now you can customize messages you're sending to your clients. Another new control we have is WebView 2. And WebView 2 allows you to host web application inside your WinForms application. Like on my example, I have a Twitter inside my WinForms app. WebView control based on new Chromium device. If you heard about web browser, that was kind of a parent to WebView 2, and it is available as a NuGet package. Simply add microsoft.web.webview2 to your project, and you will see it in a toolbox, and just drag it, drop it on the form, start using web abilities in your desktop application. Okay, what improvements have we made since the last Visual Studio? We fixed a lot of reliability bugs. So initially, our WinForms designer that was supporting .NET Core, .NET 5, and .NET 6 now applications was in the making, right? It was in the preview. So in .NET 6 and in Visual Studio 2022, it is a much better, mature, and reliable version. So I highly recommend if you're building your WinForms applications for Core, .NET 5, and .NET 6, I really recommend you to update to Visual Studio 2022. It is much, much better. We improved multiple controls editing. If you select like 20, 30 controls and try to move them all, these mechanisms are much better in the latest Visual Studio. They're more memory efficient. Also, we have a third-party control SDK improvements, and we're constantly working with our third-party control vendors, and they're developing their libraries that support .NET 6. And we improved designer load fast. Designer load now happens much faster, and it happens asynchronously. So when you open your form for the first time, before the designer used to freeze, and now you can go and edit other files, you can start working without waiting for the designer, and designer will load up in on the background. It also happens much faster in the latest Visual Studio. All right, let's continue talking about performance. We made significant improvements in the latest .NET, .NET 6, and here you can see the comparison of absolutely same application doing absolutely same tasks, but in the first time on the top level, it targets .NET Framework, and on the lower part, it targets .NET 6. So here, you can see a significant improvement, right? Like 262 allocations compared to just 77 for .NET 6. By simply retargeting your app from .NET Framework to .NET 6, your application will be much faster. All right, let's open Visual Studio and do some coding. Here I have an air quality application, but even before jumping into the application, I want to show you a very cool feature that we added in WinForms that is called Implicit Usings. So I opened my project file, and here I type Implicit Usings enable. I'm gonna save everything, and what that will make, it will make Visual Studio to figure out what libraries I need by default and what I should not use explicitly, such as system or system Windows forms, right? I have my WinForms applications, so it's obvious I'm gonna need those. Since I added that line in my project file, now I can easily remove that from every class of my project and just have more space for me to code. Next thing, and I don't know, maybe you have noticed it already, that my tabs have a different color. I have yellow tabs and purple tabs. That is because we added the feature to use different color tabs for different projects. It's very easy to turn it on. You simply go to Tools, Options, here Tabs and Windows. I make sure that Colorize Document Tabs by Project is on. And then you will have that colorization as well. I personally find it super useful because when I have 15, 20 tabs open, it really helps me to navigate between them. Another great visual thing that we have is different themes in Visual Studio. Before we had just a few standard themes, but now we did that in a collaboration with the open source community. You can go to Tools, Theme, and get more themes. And here you will find plenty of different themes to your taste. Let's look in this one. Yeah, it looks gorgeous. To get it, you simply click download and it will appear in your Visual Studio here, and you can easily switch between different themes. Okay, and back to WinForm specific things. Let me run the application and show you what kind of app I'm having here. That is an air quality app, as I mentioned. It shows air quality in different cities, in my case, in USA. And here I'm using user controls. Every tile is a user control that I developed in my WinForms designer in Visual Studio 2022. And my application is targeting .NET 6, the latest framework. So in .NET 6, in Visual Studio 2022, we have a full support for user controls. I used designer, I saw the user controls on the form, I was able to fine-tune the UI to my liking, so check it out. And I also have third-party controls. Do you see those amazingly looking round buttons and round edit boxes? We have a support for different third-party controls, and we keep working with them, making sure that they have a clear path to the latest .NET, to the latest Visual Studio version. If you're a control vendor, it doesn't matter if you're large or small, maybe just one person developer, feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions or issues in enabling your application, enabling your controls in the latest Visual Studio with the latest WinForms .NET 6. We want to make sure that your control port and bring joy to users with the latest tech that is available. Okay, and moving on. Here I notice that every city is a Los Angeles. So that obviously is some error. I'm gonna debug it while my application is still running. So I'm gonna bring my application to a site. I will go here and yeah, look, I added this code to test something, and it just overrides everything to Los Angeles. Let me remove it, just save everything, go back to my application, and look, now every city is the right city. And I did that while my application was still running. This feature is called hot reload. So now hot reload works for C# as well, and you can change your C# code. Your changes will be applied immediately to your running application. Here we have a hot reload button. Let me open it. And I have hot reload on file save. So I didn't even need to click anything. I just saved my changes and they're immediately in my running application. Okay, and let's go back here. I'm pretty happy with how my main form looks like, but my detailed form, this font looks pretty plain, right? I want to make it pop up. For that, we have a new API that sets default font all over your application, and you can do it in one line. Let me stop the application right now and show you how you can do it. Well, the first thing, you can just, in your main method, you can type application set default font and set it to the font that you want. And those changes will work in your running application, but they will not work in the designer. And later we added ability to set the default font in the project file, and that will work in the designer as well. So by adding this line, application default font, and I'm setting it to some font that will really pop up. And let me make sure I'm gonna command this line, so nothing here, just one line in my project file. I'm gonna run the application, go to details tab, and there you go. Very curly font, probably too curly for a business app, but for demo purposes, I would say it works. And the last thing I wanted to show you is the new way how you can add data binding to your application. So let me open my Visual Studio. Okay, in my details tab, I have provider label and I want to data bind into some entity. And the way I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna go to property window, go to very top, open data binding text, and click add new object data source. This will bring up the new dialog that we did not have before, where I can select what entities I want to add as my object data source. All right, I choose that, and I'm gonna go inside my city air quality and choose air provider. Awesome. Now, the only one thing I need to add in my details form, when I'm creating it, I'm gonna pass this city air quality, and I'm gonna set city air quality binding source that got created when I just clicked that thing in properties. I'm gonna set data source to city air quality. And now when I run my application and go to properties tab, you can see I have an air provider. So that is a new way how you can add data binding to your WinForms. Let us know what you think. We will have a detailed blog post that describes how this data binding works and what you can do with it. You can do a lot of things. We keep innovating in this area, so please give us feedback. Let us know, are there other ways you want to work with data? Do you like it? Anything that doesn't work well for you. We are working constantly with our users to make sure that we're building the right experience. So feedback is very appreciated. And with that, let me go back to my slides and tell you what is coming in the future to WinForms. So as I mentioned, we're working on data scenarios and really appreciate your feedback. We will keep adding more things in this area. We are also working on high DPI improvements. We're gonna support Pair Monitor V2, and we're gonna do more fixes and improvements in .NET 7 timeframe. We're also working on supporting the new Windows 11 look and feel. If you had a chance to check out Windows 11, it has an absolutely new revolutionary look, and WinForms will get that look as well. We have a few controls that will have the old look right now, and we're gonna work to make them support Windows 11 look and feel. And what else? Please give us feedback. Let us know what you want us to work on to improve, which areas you need some changes or innovation. We're constantly talking to the community, and we really appreciate when you help us design the future of WinForms. And today you can get Visual Studio 2022 and check out all the new features for WinForms as well as for every other platform that it supports. You can see what is new in release notes or in blog post, and please give us feedback. The best way is to do it in Visual Studio on your top right corner. Click on this icon and report a problem or suggest a feature. We go through every item there. You also feel free to reach out to me on Twitter if you have any questions, if something is blocking you, I'm always happy to help you. And check out our source code. WinForms as well as WPF is open sourced. It's available on GitHub /.NET/WinForms or /.NET/WPF and become a contributor. We got a lot of contributions in our repositories, and we really, really appreciate your feedback. So develop the WinForms future together with us. And with that, that's it. And thank you so much for your time. Ask questions, give us feedback. Have a great day.